Hi guys, well, welcome to another on the road video. This morning I took delivery of this, which is the BQ E4.5 running Ubuntu. I think that's what it is. It's the Ubuntu phone which is out at the moment, and it has only taken me one day to basically write it off as a daily driver phone. As I have received that, it's in a worse condition than the Yola was when it was first released. Pretty much when I turned it on, it didn't give me the Wi-Fi MAC address, which gave me a problem, as many things don't. But even going into the about, no sign. Bluetooth MAC address, no problem. Don't need that. What I need is the Wi-Fi MAC address, not there. Eventually managed to get it hooked up without needing that. You know, use the MAC address for security, blah blah, and I know it's open for debate, etc, etc. But it pulled down an update, which ironically enough did actually then put the Wi-Fi MAC address in the about section. Bit late for that, guys. What can I say? This is now a consumer-grade device, and I don't think that Canonical has the support geared up for consumer-grade devices. I mean, if a consumer has a problem, I can't see them submitting a full bug report. At the best, you're going to get out to the consumer what version number is in the about section, and that's about it. But that is the gap which I believe now exists, and it's going to be up to Canonical to fill that gap. There's quite a number of problems. I could go on. Like, for example, the consumer would want to put their own ringtones on a phone. Not possible at the moment, because the file system is in read-only mode. Putting it in read-write mode requires a command, and I couldn't get the command to work. Surprise, surprise. Couldn't get that to work, and you know, and that's a one-shot deal, even if I did manage to do it. In other words, you can only put it in read-write mode, you can't put it back in read-only mode after. You know, the average consumer is not going to mess around like that. I also had hideous problems with the Bluetooth side of things. Pairing it to my headset, it sort of paired, but then it wouldn't work after. You know, I can't use the Bluetooth headset with the damn thing. So that, you know, it, there isn't a decent email client on it either. And also status isn't right. It's, you know, I just hit the button on the Yola and I can instantly see anything that's outstanding, as I can on the iPhone, as I can on most Android phones. On this one, no. It's a bit of a mess. Okay, it's quite a bit of a mess. I've written it off after one day as a phone. And looking at it, you know what? How can I say it? You know, in War of the Worlds, when the journalist was with the artilleryman, and the artilleryman was going on about this great vision of a world underground, a new beginning, and going off on all this, and at the end of the day, it had taken him a week to dig just a pathetic amount, and the journalist got a realization of the gulf that existed between the artilleryman's vision and what he was actually capable of. And that's the kind of realization that I'm starting to come to here. I mean, when I look at Android, you know, I look at it on the phone, I look at it on the tablets, okay, it works. But when I try and envisage Android on the desktop as a daily driver for desktop work, I start to have reservations, serious reservations. And that's what we're looking at the reverse of here. Ubuntu has been created as a desktop operating system, and to work as a mobile phone, I think there's big problems. Not least in the the location of some of the files, like the ringtones. You know, they are in such a location that when the file system, as it stands, is tied down, those locations are within the tied down areas, and there's stuff like that that's going on, and I can see real problems with Shuttleworth's vision of having one operating system, one environment across different devices. And having had my hands on it and experienced that gap, I'm starting to wonder about other things like the Ubuntu TV that he's going on about. There's serious concerns in my mind as to the usability of all this, and I think Shuttleworth's vision is... Put it this way, if I was to achieve, to want to do what Shuttleworth was doing, I wouldn't be starting from where he's starting from. I would have to devise something from the ground up, because getting Ubuntu in its current shape to try and do what he's trying to do, it's not going to do it, you know? It needs a more fundamental redesign to be able to do what he wants to do, I think. And certainly, I would avoid, if you need a daily driver, I would avoid Ubuntu for that. I mean, it's good as a development unit, you know, to try and mess around with. But I wouldn't be using it as a daily driver. I mean, it's the stuff that I need to hook it up to is not talking properly. Various. I mean, you can't even change the Bluetooth name. On the desktop, you know, if on the Ubuntu desktop, if you want to change the device name, how it appears, the Bluetooth-friendly name, you've either got to launch a third-party application, or else you've got to get down and dirty in the command line. I would have thought that things like that would have been addressed in the operating system. No, it hasn't. And, you know, that there is a big gap between where they are and where I thought that they would be in order to justify being able to launch this as a consumer device. Nope. Big gap. So, yeah. It's only taken one day for me to completely abandon this as any kind of workable daily platform, and I'm going back to the Yola. I mean, even with the email fault and I have to manually check it, at least I can see the notifications and a quick flip does it. And the user interface on the Ubuntu phone is, you know, there's a few nice touches that need doing. I mean, the Yola has the touch interface, has the swipe control better than the Ubuntu phone. I mean, one nice touch on the Ubuntu phone would have been if you're on a lower level setting page, just a little swipe from left to right to go back up a settings level would have been great, but no. You know, there's all sorts of oddities at various different levels. Some serious, some not so serious. But at the end of the day, it just makes it, forget it. So anyway, yeah, it's a bit of a shame. I thought it would be better further forward than it is, which is one of those things. I'm just going to keep my eye on it, keep the device updating every now and then and see what they manage to do with it. But there's an awful lot more work that needs to be done, to be perfectly honest. Yeah, catch you on the next video, folks. Take care. Bye for now.